Hi, this is Sam Gabriel, and in this video, we're going to see how to build a Ubuntu 22.04 VM inside of vSphere using Terraform. Now, in a previous video, we saw how we were able to create a template in vSphere with Packer. If you haven't seen that video, I recommend you go and take a look. I'll have a link to it in the description of this video. Let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so I have here my main.tf file, and I will go in and take a look at that in just a second, but let's clear through here and run Terraform so we can save some time. But before we do that, let me actually show you my vSphere screen here, and I currently have a few VMs running, but I don't have my new Ubuntu 22.04 VM running yet. It's going to be called Ubuntu 22.04 test. We'll see that in just a little bit when it starts. So I'm gonna go ahead and run. Well, first of all, I need to know or find out where I'm at. So I need to go into a proper folder, and just doing that should bring me in to the right folder. Perfect. So let's go ahead and run Terraform init. And that's successfully initialized. Let's run Terraform apply and auto approve. This will automatically run everything for us. Definitely not recommended to do an auto approve in production. I have a whole course, a Terraform 101 course that you can take a look at. We go through some best practices and take you from not knowing anything about Terraform to being able to understand some of the basics and get you ready to take the Terraform Associate exam as well. So if you're interested in looking at that course or taking a look, you can see that in the description of that video as well. All right, so this got us started. As you can see, we're gonna plan, or we started a plan before the Terraform apply, and it's going to create one resource, and we're gonna see the IP and the output here of the VM that gets created. So let's bring this down a little bit and let it run while we go through the main.tf file and also a few other configuration files for Terraform. So you can see here on the left-hand side the different files I have. And the most important one, of course, is main.tf. That's where we're going to start. You can see the required providers is HashiCorp vSphere. That's what we need to talk to. And for vSphere to work, we need to specify the username, password, and vSphere server IP or FQDN to access your vSphere server to be able to talk to it through the API. Now we also have a locals here, so local variables here to be able to use with our templates that we'll see later for the user data and metadata that we pass into Cloud Init as we create the VM. Now we're going to grab a few things, and the data block allows you to grab things from or using Terraform. So in this case, we're grabbing the vSphere data center name and ID from vCenter directly, or from vSphere directly. Doing the same thing for the data store, compute cluster, network, and the template as well. We're grabbing all this information because we're going to use that in the VM we're creating. So in this case, we have a block called resource. And when you use resource, that means you're creating something. Okay. In this case, we're creating a VM. And to create this VM, we need a name. So giving it a name, the resource pool ID, the data store ID. And by the way, we refer to any one of these things using the data keyword here. So vSphere compute cluster is right here. And then dot cluster is right here. And then resource pool ID is required here. So this is an attribute that comes back to us from calling on this particular data type, vSphere compute cluster. Same thing here, the data store ID and so on. And then the number of CPUs that we want for this VM, the cores per socket, all these are grabbed from variables that we have in are declared or defined in our variables.tf and then assigned in the vars.auto.tf vars and terraform.tf vars. We'll see that in just a little bit. Okay, so memory, the RAM we're getting also from a variable, a guest ID from a variable. The network interface as well, we're grabbing from the data that we collected at the top here, the vSphere network and vSphere virtual machine template. So we got those. Also the disk, you can see here, we're thin provisioned and eagerly scrubbed. We're getting directly from the template that we created with Packer. And size, this is a conditional. So we're saying if the variable disk size is empty, then if that's true, then we're grabbing the disk size directly from the template. But if it's not true, we can use the variable disk size. Okay. So that's a conditional to kind of whether to use a defined disk size or use the one from the template. Then we're going to clone our template to create this virtual machine. And again, we need the template ID that we grabbed from using data from before. Then the extra config, this is what's needed to kind of configure the VM further. So guest info metadata and user data. And this is base64 encoded, uses the function template file. The reason we use template files is we can pass variables into template file as opposed to using the file function. So template file takes on a path to a template file, which in this case is the metadata that's stored in the template's metadata. And we pass to it the local.template vars. So all these variables get passed into this template that we will see in just a little bit how we can use that. And similarly, we do the same thing for user data. We also have the path and we're also passing the local template vars. And then we have a lifecycle block as well that ignores some changes, as you can see here. All right, so that's great. Let's take a look at the let's do the metadata right now since we talked about it really quickly. So under the metadata template file, you can see here we have the local host name, name, that's the variable that we're looking at. And just to remind you, if we go back to main.tf and go to the local that we passed this entire template vars map here. So name, this name, var.name, it corresponds to this name in here. And then instance ID is Ubuntu dash the name. Here's the network block. So we are using static IP here, not DHCP. The IPv4 address, once again, we're grabbing that from the local IPv4 address that is defined in the variable IPv4 address. We have the gateway, DNS server 1, DNS server 2. Search is home, that's a suffix for DNS. And from a disk perspective, dev SDA2. And that's pretty much it for metadata. For user data, here we define the SSH username that's also defined right here in the locals SSH username. Also, you grab that from the variable SSH username. And then we define the public key here. So we're passing in the public key into the VM so we can SSH into it. And once again, public key shows up here and the variable public key. And group sudo shell bin bash. And we're adding a package tree just as an example to show you what's going on. The template itself had Docker inside of it. So we're going to test and see and make sure that the VM that came up already has Docker installed as well. Okay, that's great. Now let's take a look at our output.tf is value. We're getting the vSphere virtual machine vm.guest IP address of 0. That will give us the IPv4. And if you notice, we've already finished the run here and the IP that we got is this one right here. And that's expected because it's a static IP that we've defined in our variables. But still, it's nice to output that for users. And now let's take a look at the variables. So variables.tf, and in here, you can see that we have the different variables that we've declared, vSphere user, vSphere password, vSphere vCenter, vSphere unverified SSL, data center, cluster, template folder, the variable name, the name of the vSphere virtual machine that we're using. So it's always good practice to have the type and description and a reasonable default. VM data store, network, linked clone, a few other variables that you can see right here. And finally, we can see the vars.auto.tf vars. In this, we are assigning variables. So the CPU is 4 cores per socket 1, RAM is 4 gigs, and disk is 100 gigs, and so on and so forth. You can see the rest of the variables that are defined here. And finally, terraform.tfvars, as you can see, I'm not pushing that into Git because I have some sensitive variables in here that correspond to accessing vCenter. So in this case, I have created an example.tfvars file that you can use. So you can rename this to terraform.tfvars, and here you can update and use vSphere user, your username, your password, and your vCenter IP or fully qualified domain name. Once that's all good, of course, that Terraform grabs all the different Terraform files together and works with it at once. Doesn't matter how many files you've split your configuration into, Terraform has the intelligence to be able to merge everything together as it's running. And as you can see, we have a state file here that I'm not pushing into Git. You definitely don't want to do that. There are other better ways of storing your state file, and that's remotely. So I have a number of videos talking about the state file and the sensitive information that shows up in the state file. So always be sure that you don't want to do this and run it locally on your machine. This is just for demo purposes, but for you, you'd want to leverage a remote secure storage space for your state files. And that pretty much wraps up the configuration here. So now let's go ahead and take a look at our vSphere console, and you can see Ubuntu 22.04-test shows up here. And here's our IP address that we just saw earlier, the .97. Let's make this a bit bigger. So the .97 is right here. And that's pretty much all I wanted to show you here. If you recall the templates, this is the template that we used, the Ubuntu 22.04 that we used to generate this VM, and that was created with Packer. Once again, you can see that in the previous video that I had. And finally, I want to SSH into this machine. So let's go ahead and SSH 192.168.1.97. And let me just remove this and do this again. Okay, very good. So let's test tree. And tree is right there. And let's test Docker. Let's do a Docker version. Docker is running. You can run Docker run. Let's see, hello world. It goes up, pulls the image, brings it down, and runs hello world. And everything works as expected. And we can go ahead and destroy this machine, which is part of the infrastructure as code workflow. So we can go and do a Terraform destroy, and it will ask us if we really want to do this. If yes, we will enter yes. In this case, you can see 1 to destroy, and all the minus signs here means that we're going to remove, or Terraform is going to remove these parameters. In this case, this resource virtual machine, that's going to get destroyed. So we enter yes. That will go ahead and destroy that. And if we see that in our console here, you can see that there's a task that started right here. And that doesn't take too long, a few seconds, and this virtual machine will be removed. So just bear with me. And there we go. The machine is removed now, and you can see it's gone, and we are good to go. So in this video, we saw how we were able to create a Ubuntu 22.04 machine in vSphere using Terraform, and we talked about some of the best practices when using Terraform, and we saw how simple it is to do, and it's repeatable, and we can create and destroy very easily, and we can leverage the benefits, of course, of infrastructure as code. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you in another one.